Thank you very much. I have another special guest that's joining me tonight. His name is Gordon Uchima. And we're going to do another song from the album. This is a song called One More Tomorrow. It's about two people who split up and realize they can't live without each other. So they get back together and work everything out. And till today, they're still together. So hope it stays that way, guys. Song called One More Tomorrow. Say goodbye, and you won't see the hurt in me, and I won't see you cry. I see the taxi waiting to take you out of my life. Now you can go on your way if you think that's right. We can take one more tomorrow and maybe find a way. One more tomorrow, give me time to say. I love you. Started with, we'd be flying high. I think I see the need for me, baby, still there in your eyes. We have seen some changes, and sometimes we've been blind. I know we can get it back. We only take the time. We can take one more tomorrow and maybe find a way. One more tomorrow, give it time to say. I love you.
You know, kind of Billy Goat, that some get horn, but some no more horn, you know. I'm still trying to figure that one out, you know.
Okay, Mr. K. Nahee, tell me, what kind of techniques do you use to go hunt your Billy Goat?
Oh, when I go hunt a Billy Goat like that, I go, me, I look like a stukum like that.
Beg your pardon?
A stukum like that.
Huh?
Stukum me, a stukum me, we go, eh?
Would you mind demonstrating this thing for us? And
that's the kind. Yeah. Oh, okay, they like, okay, maybe like, okay, you stay inside the Mauka area, like that, and then the Ua stay falling, like that, and then you get your weapon and you just stalk them, bro. You make like this. Stalking that, yeah.
I see, Mr. Kane. Well, tell us, when you spot your Billy Goat, what do you do? You say, hey, Mr. Billy Goat, why don't you just drop dead and save me some bullets?
Oh, no, I wouldn't try that, but that bugger ain't no work like that, you know. Me, after I pass stalk him, I get the gun, and then after that, you know, you see the Billy Goat.
Yep.
And then you raise your weapon, you make cock eye real hard, you go like this. And so that, when you let go, you see four, you get more chance. You know what I mean? And then after that, you just blast them. Boom!
Sounds very interesting,
oh, yeah,
Mr. Kane.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you tell our audience out there, what do you do with Mr. Billy Goat after you shoot him?
After I pass you to my dad.
Yep.
Or me, I belong to the kind of ecological, the kind society, like that, so we don't waste nothing, like that. Oh. You ain't find them. All right, Ed. No, okay, then. So, after I get my Billy Goat.
You're not him. You don't say much.
After I get my Billy Goat. What I do, after I get the Billy Goat, I'll pass you the Billy Goat. I'll take out my pants, Ed. I'll take out my butt comb. See that? And then I comb the fur, like that. Yeah. Then after that, we cut the Billy Goat open, him all the meat, like that. Take out the meat, you know what I mean, eh?
Yep.
And you save the fur, like that. You take them home, you use them for rug, like that. Everybody know that one, but hey, you know what the good part is? But a Billy Goat, you get like the leg, the hoof part. Mm. You cut off the hoof, eh? Mm. You take that home for a kind doorstop, like that, bro. Hey, we don't waste nothing. And then after that, you know the Billy Goat? You know the nose part like that?
Yep.
Yeah, you cut off the Billy Goat nose. You take them home. You take them inside the bathroom, man. Turn them upside down on top of the bathroom sink. Right there, brother. His and hers. Toothbrush. Hold on.
Well, that was very interesting,
Mr. Yeah.
In fact, have another bottle. Ed, what did you think of that?
Goodness. Here, this guy.
Yep. My words exactly. I'd like to thank Mr. Duke.
Yeah, well, this is a kind of salt water, like cleanser, like that.
Yep.
Gee, yeah, this bug, gee, my stomach kind of,
you just go right out the back door, turn left, go to the wooden shed right down by the street.
In the woods?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, okay, thanks, sir, but I gotta go, like that.
Well, like Mr. K. Nahee, we gotta go too. So, on behalf of my cousin Ed, say goodbye, Ed. We'd like to say aloha and mahalo, and thank you for all your support. Good night.
This is real special. They're both special. You two know. There's a song called Pretty Face. Pretty Face, what's your name? And is that smile for me? And am I fortunate enough to have your love? Pretty face, shining eyes, your skin so soft and nice. Could it be that what we have is right? 'Cause in my heart I get excited, and you can see why I can't hide it. 'Cause I'm for you and you're for me. I'm pretty face. You're so good to me. Forever I will be there by your side. love, 'cause I'm in love with you. And thank you for the love you give to me. I'm for you, and you're for me. Pretty face. Thanks, Gordon. Go to Nuchima and Seth.
Henry, where are you now? And where is your career some 10 years later?
I have more of a vision of what I want to do. And, you know, I've been around for a long time doing it. And, you know, thank God I can still do it and enjoy it and love it. And, you know, I think I've gotten better, you know. In a lot of ways, I've gotten better because of I'm more in tune with myself now. You know, there's so many things going on before, and I started to get more focused on what I do best. And I love it.
Moana Center presents Friday, July 4th, a million points of light, concert, and fireworks spectacular with the Honolulu Symphony, Sister Roby, Fiji, and lots more. Plus, Ala Moana's 1998 Nissan Altima giveaway. Bring the whole family. Be our guest.
Hey, Tim, a painter I know told me I really ought to check out this designer paint you sell here at Eagle.
Thank you. Well, I want to thank all of you for letting me share my music with you. And it's been fun just being here with you. I want to thank my good friend, Cecilio Rodriguez. So thank you for making me feel so special tonight. Yes, take care. God bless, and be good to one another. It's so nice to see familiar faces out in the dark. Join themselves, and everybody get happy, 'cause we can work it out. We are friends, everybody. Friends, friends. We are friends. Friends, friends. And I remember when I was down there. Friend, hey, what's your name? And getting off on each other, we can work it out. Everybody, we are friends. Friends, friends. We are friends. Friends, friends. And feelings are getting strong. Closeness you can feel, the smiles that are real. just to sing right out and be a part of it all. 'Cause we can work it out, everybody. We are friends. For as simple as it was, I think it was really well put together.
Thanks for helping us kick off our 10th anniversary celebration of Island Music, Island Hearts. Hey, if you enjoy Henry Capone's music as much as I do, watch for his latest CD release, Home in the Islands. And be sure to be here next week when we'll feature the legendary group Olomana with Jerry Santos and Haunani Apollyon. Till next week, I'm Russell Shimoka. Aloha.
Yeah, and humans will know at last that intelligent beings from other planets live beside them, disguised as Earthlings.
That's right, but obviously we can't host the premiere on E like this. But I bet I know who you're going as.
That's right.
Hey, I think I'm going to go as that downtown Julie Brown, you know, that gossip show diva, the one that spins and talks with her hands, so that I can grab Will Smith as he walks down the red carpet. But who are you going to go as?
How about this?
The stars seem to love Steve Kometko. What do you think? Too tan?
Not bad. Try another one.
What about this one?
Come on, it's funny!
Nah, you're just not believable as John Henson. Without having all those spoons floating around your head, it doesn't work. Try another one, quick.
Hey, folks.
Getting warmer. Ooh, sexy. But the wrong planet. Try again.
Okay, I got it.
How about I go as Todd Newton, huh?
Todd Newton? You always go as Todd.
Yeah, but this Todd suit fits me so well, and the celebrities are really starting to relate to him. I mean, the supermodels love him.
All right. Well, listen, I think we better get moving, because the Men in Black premiere is up next on E!, so... Ready?
Oh, I'm so ready.
Jerry, beam us over.
Wow, hey, what a rush. Thanks a lot, Jerry. We made it. Safe and sound, Julie Brown here. And this is Todd Neutron.
Hi, everybody. Julie, that's Newton.
Oh.
Todd Newton, when we're in this form, Newton, like the cookie. Hi, everybody. We're here in Hollywood, California at the famous Cinerama Dome on beautiful Sunset Boulevard. And believe me when I say, Julie and I are ready to save the world from the scum of the universe.
Well, actually, I think that's a job for the real Men in Black, Todd. So I think I'm going to stick to interviewing stars instead of picking fights with any star travelers.
That's fine. You take the safe road, my love. But I, on the other hand, am keeping my eyes out for signs of otherworldly beings that are here tonight to try to mesh in with all the big names who have come to see Men in Black.
Well, there's two people you don't really have to worry about. I mean, Tommy Lee Jones, right, and Will Smith. They've done enough fighting with aliens. and told enough aliens to back off that they'll keep us safe.
You know what, Julie? I'm starting to get the impression down here in the pit of my soul that you don't think I can fight these aliens.
No.
Come on. Well, I went through this strict training regimen just like all the other men in black. I've got the Ray-Bans like they wear in the film.
Yeah, but...
You know, in fact, these are the actual Ray-Bans, the Ray-Ban Predators that we're going to be giving away to all the stars that show up tonight.
Unbelievable. Well, actually, I do feel very, very safe standing next to you.
And so you should, young lady.
Big, big, wide shoulders here.
That's right.
Also, I feel very safe because we have the lovely and talented Jules Asner. She's going to help us out tonight. In fact, she's across the road with the fans. So, Jules, give it up.
Thanks a lot, Julie. You know, I'm wearing my Ray-Bans, and I am over here with the fans.
Bust it out.
Bust it out.
Why are you here tonight? Who are you excited about seeing?
Will Smith.
Yeah?
All the way. Bust it out.
Yeah? Now, a lot of people have traveled a long way. Now, this lady, now, where did you come from today?
I'm from New York, Queens, New York, and glad to be here.
Okay. And are you excited about seeing Will Smith?
Yes, I am. The aliens against the good guys.
Okay. Listen,
I'm trying to find out who's going to win.
Okay, back to you, Julie and Todd.
Now, you know, those fluorescent pink hats are protective gear that we haven't been issued just yet.
Well, thank goodness.
Later on in the night, we will hopefully come through with those. But right now, let's get down to some alien butt-kicking business.
Oh.
Now, while I go take my place at the end of the line, Julie, why don't you tell everybody what the movie's actually about?
You be careful walking down there. Watch
okay,
out
crime
above
fighters.
You, around you, and everything, okay? Now, just who are these men in black? Get out, Todd. What's their secret mission? Could beings from outer space really be living here disguised as famous directors and politicians? What about me? I have a feeling we are not alone anymore.
We'll take it from here.
Who the hell are you?
INS Division 6.
There is no Division 6.
That's right. Division 6 doesn't exist. For Earthlings, anyway.
Put up your arms and all you flippers.
Academy Award-winning actor Tommy Lee Jones plays the world-weary founding member of the Men in Black, a team of secret agents that track extraterrestrial aliens who land on Earth. Independence Day's Will Smith plays Lee's latest recruit and trainee.
I don't suppose you know what kind of alien life form leaves a green spectral trail and craves sugar water, do you?
Oh, wait, that was on Final Jeopardy last night.
Men in Black also stars Linda Fiorentino, Rip Torn, and Vincent D'Onofrio as the evil space creature.
Is that letter?
The leader of this ragtag team of aliens and humans is director Barry Sonnenfeld.
The comedy style... it's very flat. It's not sort of jokey, but it's sort of having people say funny things, but not acknowledging that they're funny.
I want to get some coffee. You want some coffee?
No, thank you. I'm fine.
Wanga!
Wanga!
How you doing, fellas?
Okay.
That's not decaf, is it?
Viennese cinnamon.
What was...
away from home. Missing home only when we are away. A sunny day is not quite the same as the ocean blue at home in the islands, at home. In the middle of the sea, and we're two happy guys, under Hawaiian skies, living the life of the gypsy musician, and it's hot on our heads, and the lady of our hearts is miles and miles and miles away, yeah. Home in the islands, at home. Middle of the sea.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen and friends, both here in the studio and out there in Hawaii. We are very happy to be here at KGMB. So glad they invited us. And we welcome you all to the first show of Island Music, Island Hearts, dedicated to the year of the Hawaiian. Very good, everybody, very good. Nice to have you all here. Clap some more. I'm so nervous, I tell you. There's no other place I'd rather be than home in these islands.
islands in the middle of the sea. There's no other place we'd rather be than home in the royal in the middle of the sea. Keeping real close to a family of friends, taking it easy in the tropical breezes. At home in the islands, at home. At home in the royal, at home in the tropics, at home in the middle of the sea.
What did the series mean to you both? What did it mean to your careers?
Well, first of all, it meant that we, in our minds, that we were somebody.
Yeah, we were asked to do it.
You know, that we were good enough to be a part of that particular program, Island Music Island Hearts.
Yeah. Mm.
So it validated your coming of age, your existence.
I think more than validated it, just it probably did that too. But more than anything, it was like. Tantaran.
Yeah.
You know, it's like tantaran.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, if anybody on the mainland watched that, they would never understand what tantaran is. But I know all the local people are going,
that's what they were doing. They were tantaran.
Oh, they think they big time now.
Yeah. You know, and in the way we did, it was like, hey, you know, not anybody gets on. I mean, when you think about television specials before, most of them came from the mainland. If they did anything here, it was the biggies like Lucky Luck and
Don Ho.
Don Ho. And Hilo Hattie, them guys, you know, it's like, wow, we're going to be on this show. So
on TV.
On TV, yeah. You know, we're just from Kalihi. We're just simple boys from Kalihi, but we're going to get to wear nice lays and go over there and act.
Yeah.
We're so used to singing with each other now that, you know, if I'm going to take the lead, I know exactly where Roland's going to go, and vice versa.
Yeah.
So I think it's because, you know, we've lived all these years together. We've been singing since we were kids. You know, we always tell people that when the doctor slapped the popo, we didn't cry. We just started singing.
So, hey, all right.
So the...
Also, with us tonight here in the show are
three friends, surprise guests, actually, that will be coming on with us a little bit later for all of you to enjoy, ourselves as well.
Hello.
Well, the Booga Booga is going to be here.
Remember those guys?
You know, just then. Snap. So I'll go one snap. Ready? One, two, three, and one. Don't wait too long. They might, you know, go off beat. Go. This is a song that was written for us by our friend Brother Nolan, who will be on here. Island Music, Island Hearts, dedicated to the Year of the Hawaiian in about two more weeks from now. So watch for him. My tropical baby, my little empress down at Waikiki. Oh, that's neat. Your hips, they sway like the coconut tree.
What big hips you have.
You're such a sweetheart to me. My tropical baby, your hair, your body always tickles me. To see you dancing right in front of me. It's always more than what the people see. Because the way you wink your eyes at me, it blows my senses like the corner breeze. Well, darling, open your eyes and see that I want you to belong to me. My tropical, tropical baby, my little empress down at Waikiki. I'm your Hawaiian boy waiting patiently for you to marry me. Because the way you wink your eyes at me, it blows my senses like the corner breeze. Oh, darling, open your eyes and see that I want you to belong to me. My tropical baby, my little empress down at Waikiki. I'm your Hawaiian boy waiting patiently for you to marry me, for you to marry, for you to marry me.
Did you create these particular monsters?
Well, you know, I've been a fan of films, you know, science fiction and horror films since I was 10 years old. That's when I decided I wanted to be a makeup artist. And it's just, it's, you know, like a dream come true for me. You know?
Well, it's a bit different being a makeup artist with that kind of look. It's not exact. Well, I don't wake up in the morning and go, oh, I want to look like that today.
Well, I've always been a little twisted, you know. I never really, I don't understand why I don't want to make up beautiful women. Instead, I usually do, you know, hideous monsters and stuff, but I enjoy it.
Yeah. Well, for all those people out there that haven't seen the movie, of course, yet, we don't want to give it away, but if you could sum it up, what's it like?
It's a blast.
All right. Well, seeing that you gave the right answer, guess what we've got for you? We've got a pair of Ray-Bans, another pair that you can hang on to.
Excellent.
And help protect us here down on Earth. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, I tell you what, here are some things to examine when trying to identify a space alien. And stick with me, Rick, because it's claws, sweat, and gills. Also, be very suspicious of spam lovers. Coming up, we'll be talking to the famous Earthlings like Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones. But until they arrive, you stay right where you are, and we'll be right back.
Oh, don't tell me we only got that powdered stuff of cream again. I hate that stuff.
No, the Greek is a twaka.
Well, it's good.
Yeah. You guys get along all right?
No, it's a
Don't work too hard.
So, you guys seen the Wangers?
Sure you don't want some coffee?
Hey, welcome back, one and all, to the premiere of Men in Black, live from Hollywood. Yes, one of the summer's hot mega flicks, and here I am with one of the stars of the movie, Rip Torn, and my gosh, I'm one of the lucky ones. I've seen your performance already. We don't want to give the movie away, but what was it like?
I'm the director of Men in Black, and I have to make sure that Rip knows
And then I know what
come
to
on
say.
In. That
but that's why, I mean,
Sure, I love Will and Tommy, but that's why I did the movie.
Oh, sure.
Well, I'm sure. Well, with Will, there was a lot of ad-lib going on, but with you, yeah. you had to like keep it all intact, right?
Yes, absolutely.
My
daily cigar that he had under the tent.
Well, that was your...
I hear myself. He gave me a cigar.
That was your character,
he came in
though.
Show me before the scene. He said, if you do this right, mm-hmm. you'll get this. I swear, that's the truth.
So how many cigars did he get?
You know, Rip was great. He didn't cost me a lot of cigars. Tommy cost me about 2 cases of cigars.
Okay. Well, I'm sure that both of you will be smoking a hoot at the party with the success of this movie tonight. Thanks so much for stopping by. And good luck with everything. You've got some projects. I know that you're on Broadway.
Yes.
They were happy to have you. And there's some also new projects coming up.
With Marlon Wayans. And having a great time.
All right, then. Well, enjoy yourself on the big screen tonight. Thanks so much. Hey, Jules, how's the crowd doing out there, darling?
Let me tell you, the fans are going crazy, you know. And a lot of people think it's very appropriate we're having a big premiere of a movie starring aliens right here in the heart of Hollywood. And there are a lot of fans out here of sci-fi movies. Now, what's your favorite sci-fi movie?
It has to be Independence Day.
Now, would that be because of Will Smith?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, did you see him? He just arrived.
Yeah.
How do you look?
I mean, he had his little sunglasses on. I think the movie's going to be good. He looked great.
He's looking great. All right. Now, are you a fan of Will Smith, too?
Yes, he's so cute.
And did you see him just get here?
Yes, he looked good.
Yeah? Now, what kind of, do you like him better as a singer or as an actor?
As an actor. He's my favorite actor. He's just so great. He is hilarious.
Yeah? And what about you?
I love Will Smith.
Yeah? What, now, were you a big fan of Independence Day?
Uh-huh.
Yeah? Now, do you like him as a singer or as an actor?
Actor.
That's great. Let me see. Now, this has been so incredible, and the effects in this film are absolutely fantastic. And now we're going to take a look at a little bit more about what goes on behind the scenes.
I was really fascinated watching the movie and how much comedy was done in the special effects.
You know, so what's really weird is, as an actor, you work for 16 weeks making a movie, and then when you see it, it's like you weren't even there, you know, because the special effects are adding so many different elements.
Fire on three. One, two, three.
It's difficult because, one, you have to sort of help the actors through what's going to be there. You know, they have to trust me a little bit, and I have to pretend that I know what it's going to look like, because I don't know either, but I have to pretend I do.
Eyes, you have to follow it.
Eyes and head.
Better from here.
So a lot of the creatures in the movie are all designed and created in the computer. And computer graphics designers are not funny, you know? And I had to make them make funny, interesting creatures.
Get any idea how much that stings?
My favorite scene in the movie was the tunnel scene. I thought that was so... I was laughing like nonstop during that. That was a very difficult scene to shoot. It was all blue screen, and obviously we weren't going upside down in a tunnel.
You know, some of the best special effects ever committed to film are in Men in Black.
He said it, Men in Black, and if there's one guy that definitely looks good in black, it is Antonio.
Thank
you so much for stopping by. Now,
no,
you have no clue, nothing about this movie right now,
no.
Right?
No, it looks good. The previews looks really cool. So well, I can't wait to see it.
Well, what do you think about Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones just pairing up together?
I think it's great, man. They're the Men in Black, man. I myself am a Men in Black tonight, too. You know?
Certainly are. So what's going on with Antonio?
I'm starting a movie called The Big Hit, directed by Kirk Wong with Mark Wahlberg, and they're casting the rest of the cast right now. So I'm going to be going to Toronto in the 15th of July.
Well, we look forward to coming out and seeing all your new stuff. You
no
look
problem.
Great in black, and we've got another guy, our very own guy, Todd Newton. Neutron,
right,
who
now,
looks great in black. Go
Julie,
ahead. Yes.
One of us is Lowell Cunningham, creator of the Men in Black comic books. The other is Todd Newton from E! Entertainment Television. Let's give them just 1 second to guess and see if they can guess. I don't think they can do it.
No, no.
I'm Todd.
I'm Lowell.
This is Lowell. Nice to meet you.
Together
we are official Men in Black. Now, you are, again, the creator of the Men in Black comic series. How did you come up with this idea for a storyline?
Well, I based it on UFO folklore that I was fortunate enough to hear from a friend, Dennis Matheson, who I hope is watching this program.
I'm sure he is, aren't they all? Come on, Lowell.
And he told me how in the UFO circles there are mysterious men in black who dress a lot like I'm dressed.
A lot like us, yes.
A lot like you're dressed right now. And when there have been UFO sightings, they appear and say, oh, no, there wasn't. You didn't see it. It never happened.
Right.
And it just got my mind racing, and I said, that belongs on television.
Now, how long ago was it, did this idea come to you?
It's been almost 10 years since I started working on it. It took me a couple of years to sell the comic book, and then a couple of years after that, we signed the movie deal.
And now tonight, after 10 years of blood, sweat, tears, and battles with undescribable aliens, it all comes down to this beautiful summer night in Hollywood, California. It must be completely exciting for you.
It is fantastic. I'm extremely fortunate.
Now, how did you feel whenever they found out, whenever they told you that you were going to have Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones in your film?
I thought it was great. From the word go, everything has been done the right way.
It's all coming together.
It is. I couldn't imagine it being any better.
Well, I see you have your protective Ray-Bans.
I
wish you the best of luck, and I'm on your side in the universe. My cohort in crime, downtown Julie Brown, what's happening at your end of the black carpet tonight, huh?
Thank you, baby. Well, here's a Men in Black information for you. More than 30 puppeteers were employed on this film to bring the aliens to life. Now, talk about a relationship with strings attached. Don't go away or you'll miss a close encounter with some star-studded dudes, some star-studded babes, and a trip to the post-premiere party. We'll be right back.
It takes a satellite can beam images to your TV.
Mission.
Duration of stay?
Lunch.
Any fruits or vegetables?
The transport from Genderpoint has docked. It's routes of outlook. Please meet your party outside the detainment area.
You want to stay away from that guy. He's grouchy.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a beautiful night to be in Hollywood, California. This is E's live coverage of the world premiere of Men in Black. What are you doing?
Waving to some people across the street.
I'm Todd Newton. This, of course, is Tia Carrere. And the last time we were together, you made me a gift. You didn't buy it. You made it.
Yes, it was straight from the heart.
It was a beautiful fertility necklace. That's all that needs to be said.
Yes, my girlfriend laid it upon you, though.
That she did.
Yes, she did.
That she did. So last time, we're fighting disasters. Tonight, we're fighting aliens. Are you pumped about this film?
I've been pumped about this for a long time. I think a lot of people have been waiting for this movie, and I can't wait to see it.
Absolutely. Big Will Smith fan you are,
yeah,
right?
I love Will Smith. He's a nice guy. And Tommy Lee Jones, and I can't wait to see the two of them together.
Now, you've got a new film coming out that we need to keep an eye out for, right?
Yes, it's called Call, and it's coming up from Universal August 26th, and I've got long red hair and green eyes, and I'm...
Yes! Yes! Long red hair and green eyes. Now, you know, last time you gave me a gift, and I knew you were coming tonight, so I have something for you.
I have.
Yeah, I might explode, right? I have an official pair of Men in Black Ray-Ban sunglasses.
To replace my other Ray-Ban sunglasses, because Ray-Ban's the only brand to wear.
Absolutely. That's all we wear. Julie Brown, back to you. Have fun tonight.
Thank you so much. I think you two will be getting free Ray-Bans for the rest of your life. Here I am standing, well... Actually, I'm standing in the shadow of Carl right here. How tall are you?
How good a crowd as we're having here in KGMB, I tell you. We have recorded many really wonderful and beautiful and special songs. On our CD, there are 16 songs altogether. It keeps going on for what seems like an eternity. We recorded the song originally, the one we're going to do for you now, on an album that the brothers did, I can't even remember the year, 79, I think, on Kauai. The album is called Ho'ala, and we are looking forward to having that album released on disc real soon, too. This song was written by Dennis Kamakahi as a marriage proposal for his fiancée. It's called Puohone, and to dance it for you now, we ask once again for Our Lady of Hula, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Laina Ala Haini Kalama. It has been decided that in this lifetime I shall give my love just to you, and I place you in a verdant and beautiful valley compare you to a honey flower that lies peacefully in the calm. Chooses to kiss the dew of Makiki. And I shall be your special friend, hiding in the mist of the mountains. Times as you stand before us, that we wish to be as Ie'ie vines from our district of Leilono, to wrap ourselves round you and protect you from all unkind things. So we hope that you will accept this, our pledge of love. For our song is dedicated to you, our honey flower, precious and sweet, that shall never fade us in love and beauty. Thank you, Allah.